And of all times, Soup Kennedy, selected this time to come and retrieve an old shirt of his, left aboard the Reindeer from the trip he sailed with Clam. He had espoused Clam's side of the quarrel with Nelson. Also, he had been drinking in the St. Louis house, so that it was John Barleycorn who led him to the sandpit in quest of his old shirt. Few words started the fray. He locked with Nelson in the cockpit of the Reindeer, and in the mix-up barely escaped being brained by an iron bar wielded by irate French Frank. Irate because a two-handed man had attacked a one-handed man. If the Reindeer still floats, the dent of the iron bar remains in the hardwood rail of her cockpit. But Nelson pulled his bandaged hand, bullet perforated, out of its sling, and held by us, wept and roared his berserker belief that he could lick Soup Kennedy one-handed. And we let them loose on the sand. Once, when it looked as if Nelson were getting the worst of it, French Frank and John Barleycorn sprang unfairly into the fight. Scotty protested and reached for French Frank, who whirled upon him and fell on top of him in a pummeling clinch after a sprawl of 20 feet across the sand. In the course of separating these two, half a dozen fights started amongst the rest of us.